waiting and wondering.
A group of Littleton seniors still doesn't know when they can go back 2 days after a deadly fire broke out at their complex.
Denver 7's Thomas Hoppo talked to people desperate to get back home.
I'm doing well considering what we've gone through the last 24 hours.
As soon as I opened my eyes, I could not see. The smoke had filled my apartment that much just coming under the door.
People like Jane and Carlene are currently without a home after a fire broke out inside a unit at the Windermere senior apartment in downtown Littleton.
People screaming fire. So I went out on my patio and saw all kinds of commotion.
Saturday night, Carlene, Jane, and 10 others stayed here across the street from their apartment. All they're doing now is waiting until they're able to go home.
Sometime during Monday, but now that we were hearing that it's going to be moved to Tuesday before they tell us if we can go back in. They're doing assessment of the air and the asbestos. We cannot get in there. Nobody can.
What matters for some people now is the medication they left in their apartments. But thankfully,
Red Cross took care of me. And you have no idea. I have a new medicine that I did not realize. I wasn't thinking about when I grabbed everything.
While these folks wait until they're allowed back home, they grieve for the one who won't be able to.
We have heard that the gentleman that died was in the room that burned. I feel very bad about it, and of course they said it's his birthday. So I mean that, if they had plans for last night or today, you know, sometime, it's tough for anybody.
For now, they're thankful they can wait together.
We've gone through all kinds of different things in our lifetimes.
In Littleton.
So this is just another chapter in the book.
Thomas Hoppo, Denver 7.